How do you now approach the Edmonton game as far as resting starters, et cetera, or potentially doing
something? Well, you know, that's something that we have to look at. You know, of course, we know we always want to win every game that we're in, and it doesn't matter who we play, we have to be able to win those games. So, you know, we'll look at the roster, and we'll check everyone out and see exactly how we're going to line up against these guys.
Are you more tempted to play your starters next week, at least on offense, because they need to get back in a groove?
You know, that's one of those things to where, being able to have a roster of only 42 men, you know, you got to see how long do you play them. Do you approach it as a preseason game, or do you approach it as that tune-up, you know? So there's a lot of questions and concerns that goes into that.
How's Chris Getzlaf?
Well, he's dealing, I think it was a knee injury. I can't tell you the extent of it right now. But, you know, I think he'll miss some time. I'm not sure how much.
Your defense was visibly upset after the game. Do you know what the issue was?
That we lost. And, you know, the guys, they did some good things early. And, you know, like I said, the guys don't want to be scored on. And, you know, we got scored on, and guys were a little pissed about that. But at the end of the day, we got to keep them out of the end zone.
Same time, a comment like the one Dwight Anderson made, is that one you'd rather stay in the room than be made out in public?
You know, hey, Dwight has some things to clean up. And, you know, as far as we can't make comments just because we're frustrated. And that's a sign right now that we're not mentally tough enough in a couple of different areas to be able to win those big games. It's not about being frustrated and talking about it. It's about us doing our jobs 100% of the time.
Is the Corey Sheet situation with George Cortez on the sidelines another sign of the mental toughness?
That's definitely another sign of where we are. The biggest thing for me is when the points, when a team's down, that's what we have to do. We have to be mentally stronger. You know, we can't break it. It doesn't matter what the score is. It doesn't matter if we're not getting the ball. It doesn't matter if they're getting thrown on. We have to be mentally tougher.
Yeah, it was a tough loss. It was a great opportunity that we had. You know, we got to find a way to close games out. We just let it slip between our fingers. But it was a learning lesson for us, and hopefully we'll learn and be better next time.
Could you take any positives away from the game? Maybe you guys are going to be a little bit more motivated to play them next time if you do in the West Final?
Yeah, I don't know if we can be any more motivated. But, you know, the thing is, there's steps that we have to take before we get to a West Final. You know, we have to play Edmonton next week, and then we have to play BC in the semifinal, which is going to be a tough game. So I think people should, you know, watch – you know, trying to put ourselves in the West Final before we actually get there. You know, the playoffs are tricky situations, and we just can't think that we're just going to automatically get there. We gotta take the proper steps. And the first step is playing Edmonton next week.
How do you approach that game? It really doesn't mean nothing in the standings.
The way you approach the game is, if you're playing in the game, you know, you play hard, and you try to play your best, and you try to win. Not exactly sure how the coaching staff is going to approach it, but I know for me, I'm going to approach it just like any other game. I'm going to try to go out and play the best up to my ability and try to have a big game and try to win.
Obviously, you're wearing some new equipment today. How do you feel?
Yeah, I mean, I'm sore. You know, it's I don't think it's going to be that major, so that's a bonus. You know, is a little scarier moment than I think that the actual outcome is. So we'll go in, we'll see what the docs have to say today, and I think we'll be all right.
Is that that risk of always when you have to go up that high?
Well, I mean, yeah. Anytime you're going up over the middle, you know, you got a chance to get hit, and the receiver knows that, but that's not going to stop you from trying to get the ball. And you know, I thought it was a catch.
Corey says that you guys need to work on your mental toughness. There was a little bit of breakdowns in that game, I guess. How do you go about doing that?
I mean, the biggest thing is just stay together and try to stay positive regardless of what's going on in a game. You know, there's going to be plays that don't go our way. There's going to be turnovers that happen. There's going to be momentum shifts, penalties, you name it. And you got to be able to just get over it and move on to the next play and stay positive, and that'll help you propel to a win.